Welcome students, now we are going to start a new term. We are going to study a new term called equipotential surface. I will define you what is equipotential surface at first, and then I will explain what it is and its properties. Okay, see, equipotential surface is any type of surface. It is a surface in which the potential at all points on the surface will be same. Suppose this is an equipotential surface. Imagine that this is an equipotential surface. And if this is an equipotential surface, then all points lying on the surface will have same potential. That means same work has to be done if I want to bring a unit positive charge from infinity to this point. The same work I have to do to bring a unit positive charge from to this point. So any point on the surface of a equipotential surface will have same potential. That is a peculiarity of equipotential surface. That is the definition of equipotential surface. Now you imagine a single point charge Q here, a point charge Q. Now imagine a point which is at a distance P, at a distance r. Then what will be the potential at this point? Imagine that it is in vacuum. Then potential will be equal to, V will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by r. What will be the potential at a point which is at a distance, same distance r from here? Let it be Q. Then potential at P is this, potential at Q will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R, because this distance is R. Then what about the point here which is at a distance R? Same potential. So if we imagine a circle like this, all the points lying on the circle, since it is a two-dimensional, I am saying circle, will have the same potential, because this distance is r, this distance is r, this distance is r, like that. So all the points lying on it will have same potential, because potential is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by r. Now you imagine a sphere around it. Suppose this is a point of charge Q. You imagine a sphere of radius r, a concentric sphere, a sphere of radius r with the center point as Q. Now what will be the distance from all the points on the surface of the sphere? From it will be r. Then the potential at all points on the sphere will be that is an imaginary sphere. Sphere will be the same. That means, in other words, all the points around this Q, suppose this is a sphere plus Q, all the points lying on the sphere will have same potential, because it is having same distance. So this sphere, this imaginary sphere drawn around a point charge with the charge at its center, will serve as a equipotential surface. You imagine another sphere around it. This is R1 and this is R2. That sphere with the R2 radius will also be a equipotential surface. So at a point charge, all the concentric spheres around a point charge will serve as a equipotential surface, because all the surfaces are, all the points on all surface, that surfaces surface will have same potential. Okay, now what about the electric field? Now let us consider how the electric field. See, this is a equipotential surface. Let us take one equipotential surface. This is a equipotential surface of radius, it's a sphere of radius r. Now here is the point charge Q. How the electric field intensity, electric field lines will go? Electric field lines will go in this direction. So this will be the direction of electric field. So this is the direction of E. Means, in other words, the if this is an equipotential surface, this is an equipotential surface, and for this equipotential surface, the electric field will be always normal to the surface. This is the electric field. This will be the electric field. Electric field will be always normal to the surface. This case I am talking about a point charge and a equipotential surface around it. Okay, but in that case you can find out, easily find out, that E is always perpendicular to the equipotential surface. This is, yes, imagine this is the equipotential surface, then the electric field will be always perpendicular to the electric equipotential surface. So that is in the case of a point charge. But imagine another case. Suppose this is a plate with a charged plate of positive charge, charged positively. This is another charge, negatively charged plate. Now there will be electric field, uniform electric field in this direction. Okay. Now you imagine a plane, a surface perpendicular to it, like this, inside the to the board. Electric field will be in this direction, and all the points lying on this plane will have same potential. So if you imagine a plane like this, this will be a equipotential surface. Equipotential surface. Here also this is an equipotential surface. You imagine another plane, that is another equipotential surface. The potential may vary, but you imagine another circle here, another sphere here. This is also an equipotential surface. But the potential may be different. Here the potential will be higher, here the potential will be lower, because the R varies, R increases. As R increases, the potential decreases. But all the points lying on this sphere will have same potential, so that it is called equipotential surface. That doesn't mean two equipotential surfaces are having same potential. It may vary. Suppose we are having two potential electrostatic, say equipotential surface. This is one equipotential surface and this is second equipotential surface. All the points lying on this sphere will have same potential. Similarly, all the points lying on this sphere will have same potential. But the potential at this point and this point may vary. That is not same. That differs. Suppose I charge here, Q plus Q is here, this R is here, this is R1, the potential at this point will be equal to V1, will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R. Whereas here, suppose this is R2, then here the potential will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R2. Here it is R1. So the potential at different potential equipotential surfaces will be different, but all the points lying on the equipotential surface will have same potential. And one more thing is there, the electric field, the direction of the electric field will be always perpendicular to the equipotential surface. Whether it is a sphere or a plain paper, a plain sheet or anything, all equipotential surfaces, so that is a very important point, all equipotential surfaces will have the electric field perpendicular to it. The electric field, the direction of electric field E will will always be perpendicular to the equipotential surfaces. So electric field will be always perpendicular to the electric potential, equipotential surface. Now imagine that this is an equipotential surface. This is an equipotential surface. Imagine that. So imagine that if the electric field is not perpendicular to it. Suppose this is an equipotential surface. And imagine that electric field is in the direction making an angle with the normal. Then what will be the result? Imagine this is the equipotential surface and electric field is in this direction making an angle like this. Then you have to understand one thing, keep it in mind. Electric field is a vector quantity. So this is a vector quantity. This vector quantity I can resolve into two. One along in this direction, another along in this direction. See, this is an equipotential surface. And imagine that, that will never happen, but imagine that this electric field is in this direction, similar, in this direction. So I can resolve this electric field into two. One along perpendicular to it, and another along this direction. Then what does it mean? There is an electric field in this direction. That means there will be an electric field in this direction, parallel to on the through the surface of the. Then what does it mean? If you place a point charge, it will move like this. That means the potential here is different. That is, I have to do some work from moving one charge from here to here. That means that is not an equipotential surface. So, in equipotentiality surface, it is impossible to have a electric field in a other than in the perpendicular direction. If it is in another, if it is not in perpendicular direction, then that field can be resolved into two components, and one component will be parallel to what goes through the surface of the this equipotential surface. That means the potential is not same. I have to do some work in moving a charge in through this direction. So, in that case, that is not an equipotential surface. So, I am coming back. For equipotential surface, the electric field will be always perpendicular to the surface. That is a peculiarity of equipotential surface. So, okay. Now, let us see potential energy stored in a group of charges. Let us see how it how we can arrive that formula. See, before going to that, I will tell you an example. See, imagine that you are having a spring here, a metal spring. And if you are, by using some force, you are tightening that metal spring to this much. You are pressing it and you are shortening that spring. What will happen? If you release that your hand, then it will come to its original condition. So, when you apply some force to shrink that spring, what will happen? You are spending some energy. You are doing some work. And that energy is stored as the potential energy in the spring. Okay. This potential, this work done in shrinking this spring, that energy is stored as the potential energy in the spring. Suppose this is the case of one spring. Suppose you are having so many springs. Suppose this is one spring, tightened spring. This is another spring. This is another spring. This is another spring, like that. You are having a number of springs, say four springs. And what you are doing is, in order to not to get loosened, you are tightening it. Imagine that. Once you press it and then tighten it with a string or something like that. Then all these springs will possess potential energy. This spring will have a potential energy. This spring will have a potential energy. This spring will have a potential energy. This spring will also have a potential energy. What will be the total potential energy of the springs? You add all the potential energy. This is PE1, PE2, PE3, PE4. So total potential energy of the springs will be equal to P will be equal to, or U, whatever it is, U will be equal to PE1 plus PE2 plus PE3 plus PE4. That will be the total potential energy. And if you release all these springs simultaneously, if you cut the string simultaneously, all will release all the potential energy and come to its original position. Similarly, you think of this. Suppose I am bringing a positive charge Q1 here. From infinity, I am bringing one Q1 charge. Here, I don't want to do any work because there is no electric field here, no charges nearby. So, from infinity, I can bring it Q1 to this point and stick here without doing any work. So, work done in bringing Q1 is equal to 0. Therefore, the potential energy stored in Q1 is equal to 0. Because if I have to do some work, then that energy will be stored, that work done is stored as the potential energy in the charge. So here I have brought one Q1 charge from infinity, and I have done no work because no electric field here, nothing, no in the vicinity, there is no other charges, so I have done no work. Okay, now imagine that I am bringing another charge, keeping this here, I am bringing another charge Q2 from infinity. I am taking it in my shoulders and bringing it. I am keeping it here. So what will happen? This is infinity. From infinity I am bringing it. So there will be a repulsive force. This is plus Q1, this is plus Q2. So there will be a repulsive force by the electric field produced by the discharge. So I have to do some work. So I have done some work and I have brought it here and I have nailed it here. Keep it, imagine that is fixed with the gum or something like that. So what is the potential? If I release this, what will happen? Keeping Q1, I am releasing this Q2. It will fly away to infinity. So here it is similar to a tightened spring. I have brought from infinity and I have fixed it. So this Q2 will have a potential energy. Is it that due to Q2 alone? That potential energy in Q2 is due to the presence of Q1. Otherwise, I don't have to do any work. So I will say the potential energy stored in this system. I am calling this two as a system, because if Q1 is present, Q2 will have a potential energy, because only then I have to do some work. Now let R12 is the distance between Q1 and Q2. Then what is the potential energy stored in it? What will be the potential? Potential at a point due to a point charge Q1 at a distance R is given by 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R. That is the work done in bringing unit positive charge. Now I have brought Q2 charge. See, this point is P, imagine. Potential at P due to Q1. Will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 by R12. This potential means this is the work done in bringing unit positive charge. Here what I have brought? I have brought Q2 charge. So what will be the total potential energy stored in Q2? Into Q2. This is the work done in bringing Q2. That is potential energy of the system. Is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R12. This is the potential energy of this two charge system. Okay. Now, so let us write it here. Work done in bringing first charge is 0. Work done in bringing second charge will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. That is the potential energy also. Potential energy of the system will be equal to Q1 Q2 by R12. Now imagine that I am bringing another charge from infinity to this point. It is Q3. Let this distance be R13. So what is the work done in bringing Q3 from infinity to this point? See, here there are two charges. This charge will repel Q3, this is plus Q3. So plus Q1 will repel. Electric field of Q1 will exert a force on Q3. Also, the electric force of Q2 will also impose a retarding force or a repulsive force. Okay. So, what will be the work, repulsive force work done? Imagine that Q2 is not here. Then what will be the work done in bringing Q3 from infinity? It will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q3 by R13. Okay. So, W3 work done in bringing will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q3 by R13. But that charge alone is not here. Here there is Q2 also. Q2 is also creating an electric field. It is also opposing the coming of the, it is repelling that charge Q3. So I have to do additional work, not only this one. So imagine then this distance is R23. Forget about this distance, R23. So I have to, in order to bring it from infinity, I have to do work against this field also. So what will be the work done? Work done is a scalar quantity, so I have to sum up all the work done independently. Work done due to this force, I have worked it. Now what about the work done due to Q2? Q2 will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q2 Q3 by R23. Okay, now a third charge also has come. Now forget about this. So now there are three charges. One is Q1, Q2, and this is Q3. Imagine that I am bringing another charge, Q4, from infinity to, say, this point. This is Q4. I am bringing that from infinity to that point. I am fixing all those charges using a gum or something like that. You imagine like that. Now, I am bringing another charge Q4 from infinity. So, which all will repel that charges? All the charges, Q1, this is Q1. Q1 will repel, Q2 will repel, Q3 will repel. Because Q1 is producing an electric field there. Q2 is producing another electric field. Q3 is also producing another electric field. So all the charges will repel. So what about the work done? I have to do more work. I have to do work against the force experienced by produced by Q1. I have to work against the force experienced force produced by Q2. I have to do work against the force produced by Q3. So let us calculate the work done. So in case work done in bringing W4 will be equal to, imagine that all other charges are not there. Since work done is a scalar quantity, we can add like that also. Simply you can add all the work done. So imagine that Q1 is alone. Is this distance, imagine that it is QR14. So what will be the work done? Work done will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q4 by R14. That is the work done against the charge, force produced by the charge Q1. Now imagine that this is not here. Q1 is not here. Imagine that Q2 is here. So let this distance will be R24. So what will be the work done? Work done will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q4 by R24. Now another charge is there. Imagine, forget about this thing. Q3 is there. So this is QR34. So the work done against that Q3 charge will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q3 Q4 by R34. So this is a system with four charges. This is a system with four charges. One is Q2, Q1, Q3 and Q4. Now, so this is a system. What is the total potential energy of the system? Total potential, from where the potential energy comes? Potential energy comes from the work done. So total potential energy of the system will be total work done. What is the total work done? W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus W4. So let us see what is the total work done. Or total potential energy of the system of this four charges. Total potential energy will be equal to W1 plus W2 plus W3 plus W4. That will be equal to 0 plus, what is W1? That is 0. W2 is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 by R12 plus, what will be that one? W3 1 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q3 by R13 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q2 Q3 by R23. So W1 plus W2 plus W3 is okay. Now plus W4. What is W4? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q4 by R14 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q2 Q4 by R24 plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q3 Q4 by R34. This will be the total potential energy. We can simplify it now. I am rubbing all those things. So this will be equal to total potential energy of the system. Total PE will be equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0. That is common. You can take the all the common, the all 1 by 2 pi 4 pi epsilon 0 out. Q1 Q2 by R12 plus Q1 Q3 by R13 plus. This is gone, this is gone. Then this we will take Q1 Q4 by R14. So this is all. Then, so that about Q1. Now Q2. Q2 Q3 by R23. Q2 Q3 by R23 plus Q2 Q4 R24 plus Q3 Q4 R34. This is the total potential energy stored in this. For in the initial case, I will repeat once again, in the initial stage there is only there was no charge here, there was no charge here, so I am bringing a charge Q1 here, so I have done no work. Now I am bringing another charge Q2 here, and the distance is R12, so I have done certain work W2 in order bringing T2, so that is written here. Now I am bringing another charge Q3, so I have to work against the repulsive force of Q1 as well as repulsive force of Q2. So that work done also I have calculated. Now I have brought another Q4. So in order to bring Q4, I have to work against the repulsive force of Q1, Q2 and Q3. So all that work done, calculated. And this will be, this now the four charges are like this. These four charges will constitute, will have a potential energy stored in it. Once you release that, all will fly away, all will fly to infinity. So that is like a spring, so that possesses some potential energy, and the potential energy you have to find out like this. Okay, this video will be doing numericals. Okay, after that we will be going to capacitance. Okay, thank you. Bye.